Well, Uranium Resources is an exploration and development company in the state of Texas with two licensed processing facilities as well as 206,600 acres of mineral holdings in New Mexico. The NASDAQ ticker symbol, URRE. It's a pleasure to welcome to GoldSeek.com Radio the CEO of the company. Welcome to the show, Mr. Jones.
Well, thank you very much for having us.
It's a delight to have you today, and I wonder if you would mind outlining your professional background and the reasons that led you to this opportunity at Uranium Resources.
Well, thank you. To start off with, I'm a mining engineer from the South Dakota School of Mines and an MBA from Colorado State, a registered professional engineer in the United States and Canada. What led me to Uranium Resources a little over two and a half years ago was a great company with great bones that had fallen on some hard times. We have a terrific staff down in Texas. We've been rebuilding this company over these last couple of years. Prior to this assignment, I was in the silver business with a Canadian junior Wildcat Silver, where we took a smallish silver resource, sextupled it to the seventh largest silver resource on the planet. Prior to that, the oil sands business in North Alberta, where I was the chief operating officer at Albion Sands Energy. And we took a fledgling post-startup intermittently running machine through some real heavy lifting on the part of a great team of people, brought that online over nameplate capacity a year ahead of schedule, and enjoyed the price rise from $40 to $140 a barrel while keeping our costs at around $28. Prior to that, I was in the coal business running two large mines in the Powder River Basin of Wyoming, copper business before that, and various and sundry other assignments. I've been in the business since I was 17 years old and enjoyed every minute of it.
Well, that's a remarkable track record, a track record of success. And investors like to see that at the helm. An overview of Uranium Resources and its strategic mission could offer the listeners some perspective. Would you mind discussing your plans to encourage growth through exploration activities and/or the acquisitions in Texas, as well as your New Mexico properties, i.e. the Church Rock project, to catapult your company ahead of its competitors as the leading U.S. uranium developer and producer, please?
Well, as you mentioned, we own about 17,000 acres in South Texas. The latest 12,000 acres were a result of a transaction we made with Rio Grande Resources last fall, where we traded a piece of our Roca Honda assets in New Mexico and a royalty position we had on Mount Taylor for these 12,000 acres. And most recently, we announced that our Butler Ranch property, which we announced drilling results on earlier this year, was the subject of now a purchase of data and historical mineral estimates of around 1.2 million pounds. So this data is literally on its way to us right now for evaluation. Once we've had a chance to go through that data, and that will happen quickly, we will target further drilling on the Butler Ranch leases to confirm that resource and bring them into JORC compliance. As well, we have two operating, ready-to-operate facilities in Texas. As you know, Uranium Resources has been in business since 1977. These two facilities are located about an hour or an hour and a half from Corpus Christi and are each capable of around 800,000 pounds per year of production with a little bit of restart capital. They've been idled for several years due to the price environment of uranium. They're not profitable at a $38 a pound pricing, but they are most certainly profitable at pricing in the mid-40s and above. Oh, in addition to our projects down in South Texas, we have a couple hundred thousand acres in New Mexico, a mix of ISR and conventional resources anchored by our Sevier and Juan Tafoya projects on the east, about 45 minutes west of Albuquerque. Our Church Rock project, you mentioned, near Gallup, New Mexico, which is in that 3 to 5 year production plan.
The uranium industry has several recent mergers. For instance, the Canadian uranium producer Denison Mines announced plans to acquire a competitor, Fission Uranium. Now, in similar fashion, Uranium Resources is proposing a merger with Anatolia Energy, and it planned to relocate its Rosita processing facilities from Texas to Turkey. What an interesting idea to benefit from high quality, low cost ore deposits. I wonder if you could outline just how this merger could result in significant synergies, lowered costs, and greater output and yields, as well as increase the prospects that your company might be the next big takeover target.
Well, first of all, let's talk about the Anatolia merger. We are excited about the work that Anatolia has done on the Temresli project in Turkey. The project is located in the middle of Turkey. There's a pretty good presentation on both our website and on Anatolia's describing pieces and parts of that project. But suffice to say that for a CapEx under their PFS estimate of $41 million, this thing flows $345 million of cash, has an internal rate of return of 65%, and is a very low-cost producer. Full all-in sustaining costs for production at Temresli are forecast at a little over $30 a pound, cash costs at around $17 a pound. So this project is profitable right now in this price environment, regardless of what happens to price. That's really why we got interested. In addition to that, it brings forward production for URI by a couple of years. Our Texas properties are capable of being permitted for production. Now, this does not include the plants which are already permitted, but our Texas production properties are capable of being permitted in 2 to 3 years. Texas is a terrific operating environment for that. Provided we stay on track with permitting at Temresli, our schedule under the PFS shows production in 2016 and full production in 2017. We're very excited about the project, and we're very excited about what that brings to URI, a great team in Turkey. We're going to bring Paul Cronin, their present CEO, onto our board so that the business continuity is maintained. And we're going to maintain an Australian listing to take care of those new shareholders we expect in the transaction itself. Some 40% of the new URI will be former Anatolia shareholders. So we're going to maintain that Australian listing. And we're going to ensure that each of the steps we make in advancing our other projects are JORC compliant to go ahead and serve that market as well.
After nearly a decade of solid performance, the commodities sector has entered a period of consolidation. You know, in a world of momentum-based trading strategies, sluggish market and sector conditions can sometimes turn investors away from noteworthy companies. I wonder if you could emphasize additional plans to point your company to the top of the list of hedge funds, institutional investors, and well-informed investors.
You know, first and foremost, let me describe myself as a market fundamentalist. We believe in companies with great bones, great potential, and great stories. That's the reason I came to URI, is we, this team I brought on board immediately, if not sooner after we started, we strongly believe that this company has those great bones, and the ability to make transactions like that we plan with Anatolia is one of those demonstrations of our abilities. As far as other investment theses as we go along, you know, what makes URI different? Well, fundamentally, there's a lot of great projects out there, and most importantly, the Anatolia Temresli project that we're working on right now. What makes us different is our ability to execute and our history of execution as individuals in the mining business and as a team. We've made four transactions. Our first was the land trade with RGR, the first of its kind with RTR, most certainly. That acquisition of 12,000 acres shows some real promise for us in Texas. Secondly, we made a transaction with Energy Fuels and divested the remainder of our Roca Honda project to them for cash and stock and a royalty on Roca Honda, amongst other things. Once again, you know, dealing with a competitor to not only strengthen their position, but to positively strengthen our position in the marketplace, taking high-cost pounds like we see at Roca Honda in that $55 range and turning them into cash so that we can do other acquisitions of low-cost pounds, again, like Temresli. We announced the data acquisition on Butler Ranch. Essentially, we bought for $150,000 1.2 million pounds of historic resource estimates that we did not have to drill out. We merely have to do some confirmation drilling. So those resources are coming at about a dime a pound, which is pretty cheap in our business. So again, what differentiates us is the ability to go out and make these transactions creatively and quickly, with a board that supports what we're doing going forward. We remain active in the M&A market beyond the Anatolia transaction.
Yesterday, you released news indicating acquisition of historical resources of over 1 million pounds and drill data from more than 2,000 drill holes at the Butler Ranch in Texas. Approximately when would you expect investors to find that the Butler Ranch facility has entered production, please?
Well, first of all, I think on the very micro level, that data is actually on its way here right now by courier. Once we get the data, we'll start the process of going through those 2,000 holes. And as you would expect, it takes some time to scan and digitize the data. And we have a consultant that is ready, willing, and able to do that right now and has done that work for us in the past. Then we'll model that resource. So you should expect a JORC-compliant resource for Butler Ranch, including that modeling and a little bit of confirmation drilling, sometime in the first half of 2016 or before, depending on how fast we can get the work done. Once we get that resource built and our design team goes to design those well fields, we would expect to have that production area permitted within the next couple of years. So 2.5 to 3 years from now, we should expect to see permitting on its final lap for Butler Ranch, provided it's got the resource needed to produce from, and subsequent production sometime immediately after that. So yeah, we're talking about 2018. At sometime in 2018 for Butler Ranch, and we're very excited about that because we expect, like the pundits that forecast price, that prices are going to rise from the present $38 a pound to some new number over the next couple of years. You can debate all day what that's going to be. But when spot prices are in the low 40s, we are break even in Texas, and we can send that material to our Kingsville Dome facility. As you asked before, some of the synergies we see with Anatolia, for instance, in speaking about Texas, we can move our Rosita facility to Turkey and save about $8 million of capital on Anatolia, present estimate. That moves that from $41 million to something like $33 million of CapEx. Further, we can save an additional $3 million because we use our own staff for many of the EPCM, the engineering and design charges that you would see normally with an estimate of that kind. So a total of $11 million in synergy savings just through the acquisition, and those go directly to the internal rate of return and the NPV of that project.
Reading through some of the URI literature, it's quite an ambitious concept, moving the facilities from, as you mentioned, the Corpus Christi area in southern Texas all the way to essentially Europe.
Well, first of all, I work with a great team of people, and it was our decision to plug Rosita into the economics of Tamrezzele, something we worked with, in fact, the Anatolia staff as well. So, it was self-evident once we started examining our own asset base.
Well, as this discussion begins to wind down, I wonder if you would mind giving any parting comments to leave with the listening audience, any topicality regarding URI?
I think a summary is probably in order here. Over the 2 years plus that this new team has been working with URI, we have worked day and night to position this company so that we can do the sorts of things we have been doing over these last 9 months. We do transaction after transaction, and big or small, we are in the business of URI reducing its cost. Our cash consumption rate over the 2 years has dropped from $17 million to $9 million. And during that time, we've increased scope. We've actually increased our reclamation work in Texas, where these new pounds that we produce will not be burdened by legacy reclamation costs in Texas because we'll be done with much of that work. Rosita is on its final lap and on to Vasquez and on to some of Kingsville to finish that up, exclusive of the plant, of course. We'll leave that intact. The company itself is on far more secure financial footing than it was 2 years ago. Our investor base with RCF as our anchor shareholder has improved over these last couple of years. Once again, we demonstrate the ability to do these kind of transactions and to make this company grow and correctly position it as a low-cost uranium producer able to produce in any conceivable market. So I want to thank you very much for having us today and listening to our story.
It's a pleasure to have you, and I would just like to add, for our listeners who would like to find out more about uranium resources, I'd like to encourage them to direct their browsers to investor.uraniumresources.com. That's investor.uraniumresources, all one word, .com. The ticker symbol is URRE. And, I'd also like to throw in here, in our discussions over the years, many of our listeners are geared towards the commodities sector. However, uranium, it's not just a commodity. We're dealing with an energy source, and there's remarkable growth in Asia, particularly in China. I was speaking with Peter Spina, the president of Goldseek, yesterday, and he concurred that there are plans in China for 2 to 3 new nuclear reactors per year over the next several decades. And this amounts to as much nuclear consumption as the United States and perhaps even France in particular and the rest of Europe. That represents a solid investment opportunity for every investor's portfolio. Just one more key reason to take a good look at uranium resources. CEO Christopher Jones, we want to thank you for taking time from your busy schedule. What a thorough overview and exciting opportunity.
Thank you so much.